Hey, volunteer football fans, it's football time in Tennessee. Tennessee team number 121 is ready to take the field, and we are here at Chronocord Sports to give you a preview of the entire season. I am C-Dub.
And I am JC. Welcome, everyone, back to Chronocord Sports and our preview of the 2017 season for the Tennessee Volunteers. Really looking forward to this season, C-Dub.
Absolutely. We have plenty of returning talent to look out for. But before we get into this year's team, let's take a quick look back at last year.
Well, last season started out with a huge matchup early on versus Virginia Tech in what was called the Battle at Bristol. And C-Dub, you were fortunate enough to attend that game in person.
That was a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Over 150,000 fans there. I was fortunate enough to go to the Vol Walk and enjoy the full day. And that was a big stage for Tennessee to step up and win the game. But also last year, JC, we had some failures to mention as well.
Of course, we lost to Alabama. That was a tough matchup. But we also lost to some underwhelming teams such as South Carolina. And that was pretty disappointing. Put a little bit of a damper on our season in my mind, but we still ended up 9-4 with a bowl win over Nebraska in the Music City Bowl.
That was a great showing for Vols team number 120. Just did not quite perhaps live up to the major expectations a lot of people had going into the year. I thought it was pretty good progress, but we find ourselves this year, JC, in what is likely to be a hot seat year for Butch Jones.
Truly do believe this season is really win the SEC East or bust for Butch.
A lot of people could look at his total track record. He's put up a couple of winning seasons, and he certainly outdid the Kiffin and Dooley era. This is the SEC, and you're going to have to put up those quality seasons and win some championships, or else you're out of here.
I think anything less than 10 wins for Butch and the gang this season would be deemed a failure. And as long as we can get to that SEC championship game, anything can happen.
Now, on this offseason, we had a major addition. We went back to 1998 to our legacy and hired Philip Fulmer, former national championship winning coach at Tennessee with the 1998 team, as a special consultant, which I think is going to make a difference for these young men out here on Vols team number 121. It really adds a connection to the traditions and the success of the Philip Fulmer and Johnny Majors success of the 80s and 90s.
Hopefully, C-Dub, this can be a major source of inspiration for Butch and the team. Fulmer had a great long run of success at Tennessee, winning the championship. That memory will always stick in my mind. And up until 2008, I thought he had a good run. They kind of forced him out, it felt like, in a way, in favor of Douche Kiffin. And unfortunately, that didn't work out. Dooley didn't work out. We've been through a rough road the past few seasons until we found Butch Jones. So I feel fortunate to have Butch as a coach. And realistically, who could replace him? I mean, there's always an upstart coach from a small school that does really well, and he becomes on the national radar for coaching vacancies. But it's just not smart at this point to change regimes when success keeps building year by year.
Now, speaking of changing regimes, Vols team number 121 is having to fill a lot of big shoes of players who left, some for the NFL and some for other professions. The key component that we're going to have to replace this year is Joshua Dobbs, who was drafted by the Pittsburgh Steelers. And we have two young quarterbacks, JC, one with just a little bit of experience and another with absolutely none.
I will admit, dude, this does worry me a little bit, having quarterbacks with this little experience behind center, but you got to give them playing time. One of them will emerge. I think Dormady has the spot so far, but you never know what injuries could occur during the season, and we'll have to see, man. I think we're going to base our offense in the running game, but we have a lot of playmakers at wide receiver, so hopefully they can get the ball airborne.
We do have, in addition to Quentin Dormady, we have young Jarrett Guarantano, who is a freshman and has no experience. Dormady had just a little bit in the last season. He had a couple of drives there whenever we got ahead, and he did okay. Both these young guys seem like they could, you know, step up and do the job, but it's really, really going to come down to how much help they can get from the rest of the offense and as well as the defense.
So C-Dub, the Vols will be replacing Kamara at running back. He was drafted. And when Hurd left last season, John Kelly, he really stepped up.
He didn't get the full season as a starter, but from what he showed, he looked pretty good. He's a smaller back, you know, certainly not as big as Jalen Hurd or the power runner that Jalen Hurd was, the bulldozer. But this kid's, you know, he's got a lot of upside, a lot of those intangibles, the speed, world-class athlete right here, and it's time for John Kelly to step up. I think your prediction earlier that our running game is going to be a key component will be the case once again.
All right, so the one glaring weakness, even though we have a lot of returning starters here on the offensive side of the ball, is the O-line.
Without question. Unfortunately, we did have some injuries that plagued us on the O-line over spring, so it's going to be difficult for these young guys to step up and fill those gaps, but hey, here's hoping for the best. Now on to the wide receiver core, JC.
We also have at wide receiver Marquez Callaway and Josh Smith. Let's see if they can step up and replace the playmakers that we lost. And also Tyler Bird, who's projected to be in the slot as well. A wide receiver and a kick returner, potential breakout. Let's see him make some plays.
We have Jawan Jennings coming back. That was our main man who got that infamous Hail Mary catch to defeat Georgia last year. He's going to be coming back and hopefully showing up as our number one guy at wide receiver. Another returning player we have at tight end is Ethan Wolf. This guy was a machine, reliable go-to. He's also going to be splitting that tight end position with young Jacob Johnson, who really had an emergence in spring ball.
All right, C-Dub, let's jump over to the defensive side of the ball for the 2017 Volunteer team. Who's going to replace Derek Barnett? He was a top pick in the draft for the Eagles. He was a playmaker. He broke Reggie White's sack record for Tennessee. Who can take his spot? Hopefully it's Jonathan Kongbo at defensive end.
I believe so. All the sources seem to indicate that's going to be the case. Those are some majorly big shoes to fill. We're talking, top of the line, all-time talent there. Replacing Derek Barnett is impossible. I mean, let's just get real. But Jonathan Kongbo was a great defensive tackle as well as being a defensive end. This year, he's going to be a dedicated defensive end, and I think he's going to be able to get back there and give some quarterbacks a hell of a lot of trouble.
And we also have Darrell Taylor at defensive end. He's going to be coming up into the Corey Vereen spot. And the defensive tackles, man, they are just huge guys. That's one advantage that I noticed last season for our entire defensive line, C-Dub, is just the size. They could manhandle most of the other offensive lines in the SEC, and it's going to be up to them to be able to stop the run and hold down the fort in the trenches.
Two of our defensive tackles, Kendall Vickers and Khalil McKenzie, missed part of spring. McKenzie was injured last year, and Vickers sat out all of spring practice. Those two guys are going to be huge weapons for the Vols. We also have Shy Tuttle at defensive tackle, who had a pretty big season last year, but he had a lot of injuries again. This is going to be his time to shine. How about the linebackers, JC?
Yeah, C-Dub. Darren Kirkland, middle linebacker. He did miss part of last season from an injury, but he's racked up 111 tackles in 21 games, so he is a playmaker, and he has the experience, so he's going to have to be a leader on the field. And so will Cortez McDowell. He stepped up big last season when Reeves Maben was injured, so it's up to Kirkland, Jumper, and McDowell to hold down the middle of the field and let the defensive line get after the quarterback. Let's look into the defensive backfield, C-Dub, for Tennessee coming up.
Yes, we lost Cameron Sutton, who was another of our key components on the team last season. We return Emmanuel Mosley as well as Justin Martin. Both of those seniors are going to be looking to fill that role and hopefully can really break out in this, their senior season. And then, of course, we got one of my favorites, Nigel Warrior at free safety. Young sophomore who really made an impact last season, but he needs to fulfill all of the expectations that are there for him this year and compete with a healthy and recovered Evan Berry, who he's going to be splitting the free safety spot with.
Yes, we are very fortunate to have Evan Berry back in the lineup, and he's a dangerous kick returner as well on top of being a great safety. We also have Todd Kelly Jr. at strong safety, who is a ball hog of a player, and his stock should rise in his senior year.
Yes, without question. And also there at safety, we have Micah Abernathy, who started last season alongside Kelly. He's still just a junior, but he made some waves in his prior efforts.
All right, C-Dub, the time has come. Let's break down the schedule for the 2017 Tennessee Volunteer Football Team, starting with a big game. Monday, September 4th at the brand new Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta versus Georgia Tech. On ESPN.
Yes, 7 p.m. primetime spotlight for the Volunteers against Georgia Tech. This is really going to be a boom or bust scenario for both teams. This is a massive spotlight, and this should be a pretty competitive game, I'm hoping. I wouldn't go so far as to say this is an easy win for the Vols, or nor would it be for Georgia Tech, but let's hope that the Vols can pull out a W on this Monday night game, September 4th.
Let's mark that as a win for the Vols. On to game two here, September 9th versus Indiana State. The Sycamores should be an easy win, C-Dub. But the big game every year, the one we always look to, against Florida, this year it's at the Swamp.
Yes, this is going to be on CBS, as has been the case, 3:30 p.m. Eastern on CBS. This is the big one. Florida is looking out for revenge this year after we got that big come-from-behind victory to beat them. There's a lot of questions for the Vols this year, but I'd say there's an equal amount for the Gators. They've had some troubles off the field, and they may end up losing some players, potentially, for this Tennessee game.
Well, C-Dub, we broke the streak last season, so let's keep up that trend. Let's win 10 in a row against Florida. And this Florida game every season always seems to be a gauge of how good this Tennessee team might be or not. So if they can blow out Florida, that's a big stepping stone into the next part of their schedule, which includes the UMass Minutemen at home at Neyland. Also should be an expected win. And the week after that, though, the fearsome Georgia Bulldogs.
Georgia got beat on the very last second last year. September 30th at Neyland, the Bulldogs are going to be coming out and bringing out a really game young team. But I'd like to think that the Vols can make it two in a row there as well.
So we have a bye following the Georgia game, and then we are home versus South Carolina, who beat us last season somehow. That was the biggest disappointment of a game I could think of. Let's jump ahead a week to the mighty Alabama matchup in Tuscaloosa. C-Dub, this is always the toughest battle for the Vols every year.
Without question, October 21st in Tuscaloosa, that's going to be a war. It always is. A lot of people will go ahead and put this down as a win for Alabama, but let's not get it ahead of ourselves here. If Tennessee can win all these other games, the Florida, the Georgia Tech opener, as well as the Georgia game, I mean, I think we could beat Alabama at that point. If we have that much momentum going, this could be one of the biggest games of the season right here.
Any team can beat any other team on any given Saturday in this case. So much anticipation for this showdown between the Vols and the Crimson Tide. Let's move on to the next week. We're at Kentucky, usually an expected win, though Kentucky has put up a fight here and there. The next week after that, we're back at Neyland facing the Southern Miss Golden Eagles. So getting into an easier part of the schedule, C-Dub.
Yes, we definitely have a lighter back half. After that Southern Miss game on the 4th of November, we will be traveling to Missouri. We've had trouble with Missouri in the past, so hopefully on the 11th of November, in our final road game of the season, we can take them down no problem. I don't think they'll cause as much trouble as our opponent the following week, though.
LSU is notoriously tough, and Tennessee has quite the fight ahead of them. They did have a coaching change. Les Miles is out.
Yes, and the closer for the season at Neyland this year, a team who managed to beat us last year after our Vols team was just completely decimated by injury. November 25th, we take on the Vanderbilt Commodores, the in-state rivalry. Tennessee has to win this. If we lose to Vanderbilt again, I don't know what the hell I'm going to do. This is too much. You don't lose to Vanderbilt.
I think at that point, if we did suffer a defeat versus the Commodores, Butch is most likely out the door. The rebuild starts again, and we do not want to see that. Do not lose to Vanderbilt. If you do, you deserve to get fired, okay? Vanderbilt is never a contender in the SEC, and there is no excuse for losing to them.
that's almost impossible for me to get over. But all that, the mistakes of the past considered, I think we're going to have an improvement this year. End of the day, though, Butch Jones and Vols team number 121 needs to be playing in Atlanta for that SEC championship or else. And hopefully we're going to have a great season. Keep everybody healthy out there. And we hope that all of you have a fantastic season. Whether you're on Rocky Top or abroad, make sure to cheer loud and sing Rocky Top. Hopefully we'll be doing it in Atlanta for the SEC championship.
C-Dub, we'll see you in Atlanta in December. Everybody, make sure to follow us on Twitter at ChronoCord, Instagram at ChronoCord. We'll have a lot more content coming to you on our YouTube channel in the upcoming months. Football season's back, man, and I'm so stoked for it. We'll see you next time. For C-Dub, I'm JC. Go Big Orange.